Well, we do the last verification. We have to do the last verification that is at the beginning we had the matrix A representing the linear application is 4, negative 3, 2, 1, and negative 1, 1. Then, after the basis change in the first and in the second space, we have obtained, I write, A equal 4, negative 3, 2, 1, negative 1, 1. This matrix becomes, after the basis change in both spaces, this matrix begins the matrix A prime equal, we have written, 23 over 13, negative 2 over 13, 20 over 13, and negative 4 over 13. Last row, 1, 1. This matrix is corresponds to the basis BR3, BR2. This matrix corresponds to the basis B'R3, B'R2. The matrix A prime has been obtained by means of the matrix calculus. We have said P2 minus 1, AC. This is the formula to obtain the new representation of the same linear application. D is a matrix 2 times 2. In the second space, the linear application is L from R3 onto R2, and then A prime has been obtained by means of this matrix calculus D2 minus 1. AC, where B is the matrix for the basis change in R2. And then this is a matrix 2 times 2. A is this matrix 2 times 3. C is the basis change in the first space. There is this exchange. So the matrix of the basis change in the second space is at the first place the matrix for the basis change in the first space. The second space is on the left. The matrix for the basis change in the first space is on the right. And then C will be, since it is the basis change in R3, is 3 times 3. These two indices are equal, these two indices are equal, and then the final matrix A prime is 2 times 3. This is 2 rows, 3 columns. All is consistent. Well, now let's appreciate the meaning of these two matrices through this example, this verification. That is, I take a vector v. I choose one vector v randomly, a vector v belonging to R3. this vector v could be 2, for example, 2, negative 1, 3. This is the vector v. With respect to the basis b r 3. Now, we had written in the previous record the matrix C1 inverse C, the matrix C and D, and the corresponding inverse matrices. Now here the blackboard is smaller, I have no space, but you have the matrix C, the matrix D. Then we have also written the matrix the inverse B we have written. I cancel here these indices and I rewrite C is the matrix C is 1 1 1, the first column, 1 1 2, and 2 negative 1 1 2 negative 1 1. This is the matrix C, to which the inverse matrix C to the power negative 1 corresponds, which is inverse C. I leave the computation of inverse C to you as a simple exercise. Do you remember the adjoint matrix, the determinant of C? You have to compute the determinant of C, then the adjoint matrix, and then the transpose of the adjoint matrix is the inverse matrix. Finally, one gets 1 1 negative 1. Negative one third, and 1, and then 1/3, -1/3, 0. This is the inverse matrix. At this point, we can obtain, I cancel these basis because we already know the basis with respect to which the matrices are written. Now, we get B prime. What is B prime? B prime is the new representation of the vector V that we have chosen with respect to the first basis in R3. B becomes V prime. V prime is the same vector V, the difference being that it has a new representation, because V prime is the same vector with respect to the basis B prime R3. Here we have B prime R3, and then we shall cancel B prime. Well, the new representation is obtained by letting act. Do you remember? The new representation equal the inverse matrix acting on the old representation. And then if we imagine here 2 negative 1 3, we get first of all 2 minus 1 is 1 1 2 minus 1 is 1, -3 is -2. Second row, negative four third, +1/3 is -3/3, which is -1. -1 + 3 is 2. Third row, 2/3 plus one third is three third, which is one. Okay? The inverse matrix of the basis change acts on the old representation with respect to the first basis, and the result is the new representation, negative 2, the new representation, which is negative 2, 2, 1. Now I cancel this action. So I cancel. This is with respect to the new basis, because there is B prime, I don't write the basis. I cancel the basis also from here. The same vector B with respect to the first basis and with respect to the second basis. Now I cancel this formula for finding the new representation. Now I do L of V. What is L of V? L of V equal L of V is a vector W equal what W belonging to us two. The result can be obtained by multiplying the matrix A representing L on the vector V. Pay attention. A with respect to the first basis, B with respect to the first basis. The matrix must act on the coherent vector. If we imagine this vector here on the right, we get 8, 4 times 2, 8. Minus 2 is 6. 6 minus 3 is 3. 8 minus 2, 6 minus 3, 3. Second row, negative 6 minus 1 is negative 7. Negative 7 plus 3 is negative 4. This is all with respect to the first basis in R3 and to the first basis in R2. Now, what is the role of A prime? If we do L all the same L, but acting, sorry, I cancel L here. I write A. What is AB? AB is the transformation L of B. L of B. But with respect to the first basis here and here, L is represented by this A, and B is this vector with respect to the first basis. Now we want to compute the same LV, the same, we want to transform the same vector by means of the same linear application. But if we use the new representation of the vector, that is B prime, we must act on B prime, we must transform B prime with the new representation of L of the linear application. In other words, the first representation of L of the linear application acts on the first representation of the vector. The second representation of the linear application acts coherently on the second representation of L of the linear application, acts coherently on the second representation of the vector from the prime. And then if we evaluate A prime times B prime, we get negative 46. Plus 40 is negative 6. 6, negative 6 over 13. Plus 1. Plus 13 over 13. That is positive negative 6 plus 13, 7 over 13. Second row, 4 over 13, minus 8 over 13 is negative 4 over 13, plus 1, plus 13 over 13. This is negative 4 plus 13 is 9, 9 over 13. Equal, I cancel these computations. This is A prime. Acting on V prime, the result will be W prime. Well, what is the last check of consistency? We have to verify that W here and W prime here are equivalent, different, but equivalent representations of the same vector. This is the essence of the basis change in both the vector spaces. In other words, after a basis change in R3 and a basis change in R2, we have that the linear application, the representation of the linear application changes from A to A prime. The vectors change, all vectors change from B to B prime. But when we perform the action, we evaluate the action of the same linear application, altogether with different representations. If we perform the action, if we evaluate the action of the same linear application, A and A prime, A and A prime are the same, represent the same linear application. Acting on the same vector, the vector B, B prime are different equivalent representations of the same vector. If the same linear application acts on the same vector, we have to obtain the same result. The same result means the equivalent representations of the same vector, the same result vector. Well, how can we verify that 3 negative 4 and 7 over 13, 9 over 13 are different representations of the same vector? To the formula of the basis change. The basis change in R2, obviously. And then, what can I cancel? I cancel here, C inverse C. I rewrite the matrix D, the basis change in R2. D is 3, 2, negative 1, negative 5, already written. The its inverse matrix is D inverse D equal 5 over 13, 2 over 13, negative 1 over 13 and negative 3 over 13. This is the inverse matrix. What is the formula? What are the formulas for the, I cancel also C, the formulas for the equivalence, for to obtain the equivalent representation of the same vector? For example, the new vector the new vector V prime, W prime in this case, the new vector, the new representation of the same vector is, the new representation is given by the inverse matrix times the old representation. Question mark to be verified. If we let that, if or the inverse relation, that is W equal B, here on the left, B times W prime. In this case is realized more perhaps more convenient to verify this relation. Not this one. The equivalent, I verify the equivalent relation. Because this is D. This is W prime. This is D, W prime. D times W prime on the right, here, that we imagine here, must give W. This. Let's verify the last verification. 23 times 7 is 21. 21. My 21. 21 plus 18. 21 plus 18 is 39. 39 over 13 is effectively 3. Second row, negative 7. Minus 45. 5 times 9. Negative 7 minus 45 is negative 52. But 52 over 13, negative 52 over 13 is negative 4. And then all is consistent. That is, the new matrix acts on the new representation of the vector B and gives the new representation of the vector W. In other words, L of B, abstractly, L of B equal W becomes L of B prime equal W prime. L is always the same. The difference being that in order to transform B, we have to use the matrix A. In order to transform B prime, we have to use the matrix A prime. But A prime, AB is here, gives W. A prime, B prime, gives effectively W prime, but W and B and B prime has been computed through these formulas. These formulas four are three obvious. B prime has been computed, but W prime is not computed by means of the basis change. W and W prime are computed as the action of L on B or on B prime. At the end, we cannot, find the corresponding the other representation of W. We don't find the other representation. We already have both representations. These ones. We can also verify that they are equivalent. What we have done. P, W prime, 21 plus 18, 39 over 13 is 3. Negative 7 minus 45, negative 52 over 13 equal negative 4. Effectively, these two results, L of B and L of B prime are equivalent, as they must be, because the same linear application, if the linear application is the same acting on the same vector, the result must be the same result, the same vector, the vector at the result must be the same vector. The only aspect that changes is the representation. Here we -2, -1, 3. This is the representation of V, the first representation of V. This is the second representation of V. In the, with the first basis, A acts on B and gives 3, -4 as vector W. With the second basis, we use A prime acting on the second representation and obtain W prime. But W and W prime are effectively different representations of the same vector. And then all is consistent. The last observation, the last important observation can be this one. I cancel all, I only leave the matrices. Another test of consistency. This matrix has been obtained from by using the transformation laws of the basis vectors E1, E2, E3 of R3 for the first basis. Okay? And then L of E1 equals 4 F1 minus 3 F2 and so on. L of E2, L of E3. Let's write. L of E2, second column. Pay attention. 2F1 plus F2. L of E3 is the third column. Negative F1 plus F2. D, by starting from these transformation laws, we have written the matrix A. What is the meaning of or the role of the matrix A prime from the point of view of the transformation laws of the vector of the basis vector? Here in the first case we transform A prime, E1, E2, E3 as linear combinations of F1, F2 here, with the first basis. If we change the basis in R3 and R2, and this is the new basis, what is the meaning in from another point of view of the formula A prime equal D to inverse DAC? The meaning of the second representation of the same linear application is that the meaning, the theorem is always the same. The columns must be 4, -3, 4, -3. The columns are always the coefficients to be given for the linear combination of the vector of the basis vectors of the second space, result of the basis vectors of the first spaces, of the first space. And then the meaning of this matrix, of these elements, is the analogous meaning role of here. In other words, with the new basis in R3 and R2, we will have L of E1 prime equal linear combination of F1 prime, F2 prime. Can you notice the coherence, the correspondence? Here we have L of E1 equal F1, F2. Here, since we have changed the basis in R3 and in R2, from E, the vector E, we arrived at the vector E prime here, and from the vector F, we change to the vector F prime, we must have the same structure. That is 4, -3 here And here, 23 over 13 minus 2 over 13. L of E2 prime equal F1 prime F2 prime. And the coefficients? The coefficients are the ones of the second column. 20 over 13, negative 4 over 13. L of E3 prime equal F1 prime, F2 prime, with the coefficients 1, 1. Well, the last check is the consistence of these equalities. The consistence of these equalities shows the consistence of all of this matrix with respect to the first matrix. In other words, what do I compute? L of E prime equal, I want to verify L of E, sorry, L of E1 prime. I want to compute L of E1 prime. L of E1 prime. I want to obtain this result, but by using the first basis. This is a test of consistency. Well, what do I do now? I expand only L of E1 prime. And I show you that we shall get the 23 over 3 over 13 F1 prime minus 2 over 13 F2 prime. The other two equalities are left to you as an exercise, as an analogous exercise. I can't say here. The verification of the last two equalities are for you, are left to you. Well, now, for a moment, I rewrite the matrix D. The matrix D is 3, 2, negative 1, negative 5. What is the meaning of the matrix D? I remind you. The first column is 3, E1, minus E2. Sorry, here we have, no, this is in the second space. The columns are the transformation laws, the coefficients for the transformation laws of the basis vectors. The matrix of the basis change at the columns giving the first column, I express the first new basis vector in terms of the old basis vectors F1, F2 with coefficients 3 minus 1. This is the meaning of the matrix D. The matrix D, the columns of the matrix D are the coefficients to be given to the old basis vectors to obtain the new basis vector. Now I do the I want to do the vice versa. Inverse D equal. I cancel here below. I repeat, the matrix D has the columns which give the new basis vectors as linear combination of the old basis vector. The inverse matrix D, the inverse matrix D to minus one to negative one will do the contrary. That is, the columns will give the old basis vectors in terms of the new basis vectors. If I use the inverse D, the roles are exchanged. Here we have without prime. Here we prime, okay? Now I cancel here below. On the left, we have without prime. And then D inverse D is 5 over 13. 2 over 13. Negative 1 over 13. Negative 3 over 13. And then we have, in the light of this inverse matrix D, F1, all of the basis vector, equal 5 over 13 F1 prime minus 1 over 13 F2 prime. F2 equal the second column 2 over 13 F1 prime minus 3, the second column minus 3 over 13 F2 prime. Well, the last test, L of E1 prime equal, we want to obtain this result. L of E1 prime equal L of, what is E1 prime? E1 prime was E1 prime, E1 plus E2 plus E3. Okay? This is E1 prime. E1 prime equal E1 plus E2 plus E3. As a matter of fact, in the matrix C, the first column is 1, 1, 1, first column of C. The basis change from E to E prime in R3, in the first space. Okay, well, but by linearity, what is L of a linear combination? Equal L of E1 plus L of E2 plus L of E3. That is the sum, L of E1 plus L of E2 plus L of E3. The sum, that is 4 plus 2 is 6, minus 1, 5 F1, negative 3, plus 1 is negative 1, minus F2, equal 5. What is F1? F1 is this one, 5 over 13 F1 prime minus 1 over 13 F2 prime. F2 prime. Close the bracket. Minus F2, minus bracket. F2, what is F2? This one. 2 over 13. F1 prime. Minus 3 over 13. 3 over 13. Sorry. Minus 3 over 13 F2 prime bracket, close the bracket, equal the result must be 23 over 13 F1 prime minus 2 over 13 F2 prime. This is the logic of this test. Let's check. 25 minus 2 is 23 over the common denominator 13. F1 prime in evidence. Then negative 5. Here we have negative 5 plus 3 minus plus 3. Negative 5 plus 3 is negative 2, minus 2 over 13 F2 prime. That is 23 over 13 F1 prime minus 2 over 13 F2 prime. This is the meaning of the new matrix. The new matrix, the column of the new matrix, are the coefficients of the transformation laws that you know, the coefficients of the transformation laws of the new basis vectors in R3 in terms of the new basis vectors in R2 in the second space. We compute this matrix with this formula. But if we expand L of E1 prime, L of E1 prime as what is E1 prime? The first column of C, E1 plus E2 plus E3, the transformation law of the basis vector. We use the lineality L of E1 plus L of E2 plus L of E3. Then we use these transformation laws, L of E1, L of E2, L of E3, in this case is the sum. We obtain L of E1 prime, we shall obtain the transformation law of the new basis vectors in prime, but the new transformation law in terms of the new vectors has the same coefficient, the F coefficients, which are in the columns of the matrix A prime. This is the meaning of the basis change. We have a new definition with the basis E1, E2, E3, F1, F2. We write these transformation laws in agreement with A. When we have A prime, the meaning of A prime is the same, but with the basis vectors E1 prime, E2 prime, E3 prime, and F1 prime, F2 prime. This is the meaning. This is the general concept of the effect of a basis change in both spaces on the effect of all this on the matrix representing a linear application. At the end, there is this concept. L of E2 prime will be 20 over 13 F1 minus F1 prime minus 4 over 13 F2 prime. Linear A, in agreement with the transformation laws, with the first basis in both spaces, A prime gives is in agreement with the transformation laws of the new basis vectors E in R3 and the new basis vectors F E prime in R3 and F prime in R2. But there is perfect correspondence. These are the coefficients here. These are the coefficients here. E becomes E prime, F becomes all vectors E become E prime, all vectors F become F prime. But after we have changed the symbols, the roles of the columns is the same in A and in A prime. That's all. In the next record, we shall apply all these. This is the general concept of the basis, the effect of the basis change. This is the effect of the basis change on the matrix of the linear application, the general concept. Then we shall specialize all this to the diagonalization of an endomorphism. Thank you for your attention. I stop here the record and up to the next record. Thank you.